Welcome back. The time now is 6:42. It's time now for our Mornings with Metro segment. Today we're joined live by Assistant Sheriff Andrew Walsh. Good morning, Assistant Sheriff Mr. Walsh. So last week, NHP Trooper Micah May was critically injured, and he ended up dying while recovering from that injury from after the carjacking suspect hit him while he was putting out those stop sticks. So that led to an officer-involved shooting with NHP troopers, and Metro was an agency that investigated. So tell us how that relationship works with other law enforcement agencies.
Yeah, good morning, and thanks for having us on. And obviously, when you talk about this story, our thoughts and prayers go out to the May family and to everyone that he knew, and his friends and family and coworkers are all going to be impacted by his loss for a very long time, and this community should never forget his heroic deeds that he performed on a daily basis just by putting this uniform on and going out to work to protect this community. But with that being said, you know, from an investigative standpoint, we have an agreement with Nevada Highway Patrol that for incidents such as this officer-involved shooting, that we would be the investigating agency. Just the complexity of it and what it takes to actually investigate this type of event, we have the resources to do it when other agencies in our community don't have the resources or the experience or the ability to do it. So we just have a memorandum of understanding with them that they ask us to handle these type of investigations for them.
There were so many different many moving pieces. Again, they ended up sharing that video the other day. So yes, our hearts and prayers goes out to the May family. And we know that, again, he dedicated his life to serving others, but even saved more lives as he was an organ donor. So again, our thoughts and prayers are with the family there. So Metro released a video with Sergeant TJ Jenkins encouraging everyone to get the COVID-19 vaccine. What's Metro's current vaccination rate, and is there a vaccine mandate for employees or new employees coming on to the force?
Yeah, so currently we're sitting at about the same rate as most police departments around the country, with about a 51% rate of vaccinations for our employees. There is no mandate right now within Metro for us to do that, but TJ's video, you know, is very compelling and tells his personal story, and hopefully that a personal message like that from a person who I and others in this organization view as a leader within the organization inspires folks to get vaccinated. His tale of how it affected his health clearly sends a very strong message to everybody as to what can happen to you if you actually catch the virus and get sick.
And you all interact with the public on a daily basis, very in close contact. So again, that vaccine is helping to save lives. And so with the return of the mask mandate across most of Nevada, what is Metro's role in responding to a business or other facility if they have folks not complying? We know that's a big issue sometimes.
Right. And you know, the number of calls that we received early on during the early throes of the pandemic, where the mask mandate was out, was pushed out, that has diminished over time. But, that's really the responsibility of the local city and county business license folks to go out and enforce. We respond at times when these calls get heated or there's a potential for violence. But as far as us going out on a daily basis and enforcing the mask rule, that's not our role, and we don't have a role in that.
All good information to know. So if you have a question for Metro Police, you can submit it on our website, 8newsnow.com, and find out if your question was answered every Wednesday during Mornings with Metro. And thank you so much to our Assistant Sheriff. We appreciate you.